coach of your Lady Eagles is Dwayne Burroughs.
Courtside once again at the PEC here at Cal State University, getting set for the Eagles and the Wildcats to bring it to you. Here's the voice of the Coppin State Eagles, Dan Mason.
Thank you, Todd. Boy, Coppin State broke huddle right away as soon as the introductions were over. They were in their home white uniforms, decked out in navy and gold, and here comes Bethune Cookman, decked out in basically black uniforms, and listen to this, blood maroon and Florida sun gold. How about that for some theatrics? Chance Graham in the jump center against Amaya Scott. Tip goes to Bethune Cookman as they run it down in the backcourt. Thanks for joining us tonight on 1570 AM in Baltimore, WNSD, or the video stream at CoppinStateSports.com. Inside, Angel Golden has it, fires a three right out of the box. No good. Smith chases it down for the Eagles. And Brooke Fields crosses center court. Looks to the right. Mariah Smith gets the start tonight. Chance Graham has it. Back out front, pushes it back out to the perimeter. And Mariah Smith drives the lane, puts it in. Nice first shot there as Coppin goes on top, 2-0.
Dan, traditionally, she's an outside shooter from three, but if she can get that off the bounce game going, that bodes well for the Eagles.
That really helps another player to drive the paint for the Eagles. Golden inside to Brown. 15 on the shot clock. Golden takes it back out to White. White works the left. She'll shoot a three. No good. Dami with the rebound. She gets a start tonight, too, Ty.
Yeah, Dwayne's gone to this big lineup, and he did so against FAMU, and it paid off great with a 41-12 advantage and a 20-point win.
Chance almost has it taken away, picks it back up, pushes it over to Fields. 13 on the shot clock, she'll shoot a three, no good. Graham with the rebound, she picks it back up, throws it up there, and she draws a foul from Scott.
Yeah, I think she knocked knees with the defender.
That'll send Chance to the free throw line. 71% free throw shooter. 8:30 in the first quarter. Coppin on top by two, if you just joined us.
Yeah, see, she's still gathering herself. I think for Chance, she hit the right knee, I believe, on the left knee of the defender.
Eagles go on top 3-0 in the early going. Good to have the band here tonight. Second shot in there, too. Chance is limping slightly. She's in a little bit of pain, grimacing. Out front, Tania White to Golden, working the right side. Now, inside, up, off the glass, no good by Scott. Coppin with the rebound. Fields look back to the bench to get some instructions from Coach Burroughs. Smith working the right wing. Looking inside to Sally. She's covered up pretty well. Now Graham. Loses the ball. Bethune Cookman picks it up. First turnover. Angel Golden quickly turned away by Fields. Now she's open for a three. Pops away. No good. Sally with the rebound. 7:39. Coppin on top. 4-0. Fields slows it down now. Has it out front. Gets a screen from Sally. Doesn't take the shot. Smith will take a three. In the air. No good. One and done on that one. Bethune-Cookman with the rebound, and they are on the run. All the way. Ball's batted out of bounds.
Yeah, I think they're double-checking the shot clock. It went back to 30, and I believe neighborhood of 23-24.
7:16 in the first quarter. Coppin playing intense here so far. Deep in the backcourt. Fake. Now puts it up, a 20-footer good. Tania White has that one. That puts Bethune-Cookman on the scoreboard. 4-2 in the early going. 7 minutes in the first quarter. Fields directing traffic. Flips it over to Smith on the right. Bad pass. Wildcats pick it up. 10-foot shot in the air, no good. By White, and a whistle inside.
Yeah, it's Dami's first.
First foul on Oloyede. That will send Brown to the line, 62% free throw shooter, and she'll shoot two. Rolls out. 6:43. Coppin on top by two. Second in the air. This one's good. Bethune Cookman pulls within one. And Fields crosses center stripe. Rolls her finger around in the air. Now she's going to go for the basket. Loses the ball. Coppin picked it up. Thought they had it, but it looks like they dropped it on the in the baseline stripe. We'll get it back, though.
Yeah, it was an odd deflection. It just kind of stayed along the baseline, and then Bethune-Cookman touched it last.
That was a good break for us. Coach, looking to get it inbound. Got to hurry. They finally get it out to Smith deep. 16 on the shot clock. Smith. Nice pass to Field. Back out to Smith. And what do we have here?
Hand check, I believe, on Golden.
Yep, fouls on Angel Golden. That'll be her first. And Coppin will get another shot at the fresh shot clock that time. Ball comes inside to Dami. Slapped away, but out of bounds. Eagles will retain possession. 6:20. Coppin on top, 4-3.
Let's get it in, bro.
Ball comes inbound to Fields. She surveys left and then right. Mariah, ball is slapped away, but the Eagles take it back with 18 on the shot clock. Angel Golden clapping her hands, trying to spark up her defense. Brooke looks outside, gets it deep to Mariah, three on the way, no good. Tommy had a shot at that under the basket, but passed on it, sent it back out. Fields has it now. She looks for someone, gets it to Graham. Graham to Sally, but slapped away and deflected out of bounds. Coach Burrows is off the bench. She's trying to get the official's attention. Official. I'm not sure what he was after there, Todd.
I believe what he's saying is Sally's getting hugged on the doorstep.
Here comes Fields. She drives the lane. Up off the glass. No good. Angel Golden with the rebound. Here she comes. Behind the back. Over to White. Now White has it. 18 on the shot clock. You know she'd love to get that ball back to the paint again. To Golden. White. Here she goes. Ball's in the air. It's blocked. And Bethune-Cookman will take it inbound.
Eight to shoot.
Nice block that time. I believe Dami blocked that one. Ball comes way outside to White. In the corner. Four on the shot clock. Inside. Up. Runs out of time as the shot clock expires. Coppin will take the ball back.
Yeah, they may be going to the monitor on this because it for sure hit the window. I don't know if it glanced the front of the rim or not, but
the three officials are talking it over. 5:14 now. And so far, Coppin State have played a pretty good defense so far, Todd.
Absolutely, Dan. And indeed, it turned in, I believe, to a shot clock violation. It will be Coppin ball.
Coach Burles is once again off the bench, giving the official an earful here. But they give it back to
Yeah, they say it hit the front of the rim.
How about that? Jalinda Sally, though, picks the ball right out of the Wildcat hand. Mariah Smith, she'd like to drive. Deep in the corner. Dami, no good. Golden with rebound. Inside, slapped away. Good defensive play by Chance Graham. Back out front now. White has it. That was a great defensive play by Chance.
Absolutely, and then she and Scott locked arms down on this near block.
Inside, taken away by Graham. And Fields has it over center stripe. Mariah shovels out. Graham shoots the three. No good. That was an air ball. He was wide open, but just didn't hit. Needs to be more patient and work that ball towards center time. White.
Sally was calling for it on the block.
Here comes a three on the way by Bethune Cookman. It goes awry. And once again, Sally clears for the rebound. Golden guards over Fields. Got to be almost close to overguarding that time. Fields inside to Sally. She spins around off the glass. No good. And once again, one and done. As the Wildcats clear. Ball's taken away by Mariah. And she's one-on-one. Here she goes up the glass. Up and in. And she's going to get the and one. How about that? Mariah Smith spins towards the basket. And she put it in. 6-3. Coppin State over VCU. And there's a timeout on the floor. Timeout on the floor. Coppin State 6. Bethune-Cookman 3. You're listening to the Coppin State Sports Network.
Fans, you can visit CoppinGear.com to get your CSU apparel. Currently free shipping with any purchase of $50 or more until February 11th. CoppinGear.com, it's where the home team shops. Top early, Dan Mason with you. And one free throw coming for Mariah Smith after the foul on Brown of Bethune-Cookman. And Coppin in front 6-3.
Well, if you look at the stats so far, pretty evenly played game. Neither team shooting very well from the field so far, Todd. But Mariah Smith, she has 4 points, and she's back on the line now. She can make it a four-point lead for Coppin. Up and good. Make it 7-3 with 3:49 left in the first quarter. Wildcats waste no time getting back down the floor. Here we go. Driving, no good. Scott with the rebound. Back out front. Here's Golden for three. Got it. Bullseye. Angel Golden cuts that lead to one. Coppin 7. Bethune-Cookman, 6. Fields looks for Sally. Sally looking around. Ball slapped away, and Bethune-Cookman had it. They came from behind and slapped that ball away from Jalinda. And Walker on the run. In the air, and Sally will... She fouled her that time. The foul goes on Jalinda. Sally, it's her first.
Yeah, Walker checked in out of the under-5 media timeout.
Walker's a junior, a 5'8 guard from Bunnell, Florida. She's at the free throw line. Her shot no good. Another substitution, Kendall Fincher. 5'4 guard, a graduate student. She replaces Armani Ball. Second shot no good. Graham with a rebound. We're up on the 3-minute mark now. Coppin by one. Fields patiently. She's going to shoot a three. It's no good.
What's the bet?
Cold 3-point shooting. Bethune-Cookman right back with a three. That was Fincher. Just entered the game. That puts BCU on top by 2-9-7. 2:38.
First Wildcats lead of the first.
Got to keep working towards that basket. Graham pulls up with a 15-footer off, but bounces just out. Bethune Cookman with a rebound.
Hustle back.
White has it over to Walker. Walker inside. Brown puts it up. No good. Once again, Graham with the rebound. Chances of rebounding machine, Todd, I would say.
I would agree.
Bruce Fields. Smith. Into corner. Pushes it in the right corner of the dummy. Good ball movement to Graham. In the corner to Smith. Underneath to Sally. She wants that shot. Up. Rolls in there. Jalinda Sally. Ties it at 9 with 1:45 left.
Anytime she can get to that baby hook, either going right or going left, that's arguably her favorite shot.
Good shot for his right. Let's see what they call here. Yep, call on Jalinda Sally again. That's 2 fouls on Jalinda. Puts Amaya Scott at the free throw line. Her shot bounces in there. Substitution for the Eagles. Amaya Price checks in for Sally.
Yeah, Maya's gotten a couple of spot starts in her freshman campaign. Played very well of late.
Second shot by Scott is good. 11-9. 2-point lead, and Price has it quickly over the center court. Got to be patient. Double dribble, they call that, on Smith. That's a turnover we don't need. Quickly in the game comes Coleman, replaces Smith for the Eagles. Down to 1:26. Wildcats up by 2. Walker to Angel Golden. Golden to Scott. Back to Walker. She'll drive the paint. Lost the ball underneath. Dommy picks it up and back to Golden. She'll put up a 5-footer, rolls in. Angel Golden seems to be in the right place at the right time. 13-9, only a minute. Coleman on the right wing. Looks inside for Chance. Doesn't go there. Back out front to Price, to the left wing, to Fields. In the corner to Dommy. Ball slapped away by Bethune-Cookman. Good hustle by Dommy to get it back. Coppin has it back underneath the Price. Puts it in off the glass. That was good hustle there, Todd.
That and the ball movement with the extra pass, getting the easy layup.
Extra effort, well done by the Eagles. 13-11, 26 seconds left. And they'll probably play for their last shot here. 18 on the shot clock. Wildcats patient to probably take the last shot and run it out. Walker. 3-point shot, no good. Fields has it. 3 seconds. She puts up a 15-footer, no good. Up off the glass at the end by Coleman. And I think they're going to count this. Yes, sir.
And they're going to look just to be sure.
Vanessa Blair-Lewis off the bench. I don't think she liked that call, but nevertheless, we're tied at 13. So after one quarter in the books, good play by Coppin State. Coppin State 13, BCU 13. You're listening to the Coppin State Sports Network.
That court's out at the PEC, and after a review of video replay, that basket was waved off, so it's now 13-11. Bethune-Cookman leading Coppin State.
That was close. We watched the replay at least three times and probably one split second. Not even a split second. I would say that was a tenth of a second there. But a well-played first quarter by the Eagles, I thought.
Only down two as they'll correct the scoreboard here momentarily. It appears that the Wildcats want to deploy a 2-3 zone look prior to the inbound. We're going to match up man-to-man.
Trying to correct that scoreboard. At one point, they had it 111-13. Of course, we take that score.
I mean, 41-12 is not bad. Saw that on Saturday.
Coppin State will inbound the ball when we return to play.
I mean, I'm okay if they want to leave it the way it is now, 25-13, and then we'll just catch up in real time, right?
I think both teams now will go back to the bench as they try to correct things.
Well, as they do that, we can tell you about one of the great sponsors here on the Coppin State Sports Network. Of course, it's Town Place Suites Baltimore, BWI Airport, where you can travel in confidence and enjoy the comfort of spacious studio accommodations at Town Place Suites Baltimore, BWI Airport, less than 10 miles from downtown Baltimore. Home away from home waiting for you. That's Town Place Suites Baltimore, BWI Airport, the official airport hotel of Coppin State Athletics.
Don't forget, right after this game, we have the men's game. Todd will bring you that one. Coppin State and Bethune-Cookman right after this game. So now they put both at zero to start all over. See if they can reset it that way. That was probably the smartest thing to do. I think that will work.
Shout out to the
there we go.
Let's go, ladies.
How about Angel Golden, Todd? She's a really good ball player.
Yeah, five of the first 13 for the Wildcats. A shot from distance, and then an easy two, and she'll not await either Fields or Coleman after the inbound.
Now we're underway. Fields gets it off to the right wing to Price. Price takes a look inside. She can't get there. Gets it out front to Dami. Dami looks left to the left wing. Fields has it. Ball is slapped away and out of bounds. Well, we did lose on the scoreboard all the players and the team fouls and everything. Hope they can restore that. Fields looks inside, can't go there, has to get it back out to Coleman. Now Coleman on the front. To the right wing, to Price. Ball is slapped away and last touched by Chance.
Let's go down. Yeah, Fincher got a hand on, then Chance tried to gather. Ends up deflecting it out of bounds.
Walker has it. A little pressure there from Price. To Golden underneath. Fake in the air and a foul inside. Brown went up for it, and she was fouled by Chance Graham. That's her first.
And now pace of play has come to a grinding halt.
First shot by Brown is no good. 13-11. Wildcats on top as we open up the second quarter. Second shot, good. Eagles on the attack. Fields flips the ball over to Price. Price has got quick hands. She can make the movement if she can get a little daylight. Coleman drives the basket, turned away. Fields spins underneath. Dami, up off the glass and good.
Well, I tell you what, Dan, she got real close to having her shot blocked by the underside of the backboard and adjusted nicely.
Bethune Cookman driving the basket, no good. And here comes Fields. Brooke has it, flips it over to Graham.
Wants to reach in.
To Coleman. Coleman looking around, gets it to Graham. Underneath, Dommy's there again. Up, this time, no good. Almost there, but not quite. Wildcats have it. They get the ball to Golden. Here's Brown. No good. Chance fights away for that rebound, and she's got it. 8:08. Bryce head fake, wanted to take that shot, passed it up, got it back out to Fields. Fields with Golden. Tightly, a one-on-one match there. Chance, or make that Fields. Fields looks inside, gets by Golden, puts it up in him. She got by her that time, Todd.
That's a great no call by the official as well. Let them play. Golden was close, but no contact.
15-14, Eagles on top. 2-3 zone by the Eagles. Golden. Fires away a three. No good. Fields pulls it down. Brooke, back to that one-on-one match. Graham. 16 on the shot clock. Here goes Brooke again. She gets through two defenders and puts it in again. She slid right through two defenders, Todd, and laid it in.
It's exactly what she did on Saturday. Dan off the bounce, getting this take to the rack game going.
Here comes Bethune-Cookman. Fincher missed the shot. And Coleman has it. Popping up by three.
Push on.
Pushing down that court. Fields a fire away at three. No good. Underneath, Graham has it. No good on the second try. That's all they get, though. Bethune-Cookman coming the other way. Here come the Wildcats. Bounce pass underneath. Laid in by Brown. Chaz Brown gets her team back within one. 17-16, 6:22, first half. Fields to Graham. Graham slices to the right, gets it over in the right corner. Now it goes to the left with Fields. One-on-one against Golden. That is a dogfight right there. Back to Graham on the right. Good. 3-point play by Chance Graham. Popping by four, 2016, 5:55 left. Walker has it out front. Now, Fincher, air ball. Graham lets it go out of bounds. Substitution, Alyssa Jones comes in, and Chaz Brown will take a break. How do you like that matchup, Todd, with Brooke? And on the other side, you've got Angel Golden. That is one defensive matchup. Very intense. Now Brooke behind the back. Underneath to Dommy. She's tied up. Let's see what they call here, but the Wildcats take it away. And they're on the run. Golden. Another three ball. No good this time. Coleman gets a rebound, but Wildcats have it. Underneath the second chance, no good, but this one's tied up. Possession arrow to Bethune-Cookman.
To answer your question, Dan, Andrew Golden with five, Brooke Fields with four. So to this point, they're nearly canceling each other out. Now it's up to everybody else.
The intensity of the defense is something else. Play called by the Wildcats. Ball comes in. Up. A little floater by Scott is good. Fire. 5:07. 2018 Coppin State. Graham has it. Flips it over to Price in the corner. To Coleman. Price out front. Fields is open. Covered up by Golden pretty quick. Fields to Dommy. Back to Fields. She's going to shoot the three again. Good. Threw it up over the top of Golden and sunk it. 23-18, a five-point lead. Golden has it. Ball slapped away by Fields. And they are tight. Fields is in her face. I don't know what she's screaming, Todd, but it's loud. No basket underneath. Fouls on Dommy. We've got a timeout on the floor. Your score, Coppin State 23, Bethune-Cookman 18. You're listening to the Coppin State Sports Network.
Out of the media timeout, 4:19 to go in the opening half, 23-18, Coppin in front of Bethune-Cookman. Fans traveling confidence and enjoy the comfort of spacious studio accommodations at the Town Place Suites Baltimore, BWI Airport, less than 10 miles from downtown Baltimore. Your home away from home is waiting for you. Town Place Suites Baltimore, BWI Airport, the official airport hotel of Coppin State Athletics. Todd Morley, Dan Mason with you. 23-18, Coppin with the advantage.
So far in the second quarter, now Coppin State shooting 62%. Bethune-Cookman has it out front. Camry Harris in the game. That's a substitution for the Wildcats. Harris to Golden to White. Harris will shoot. Good. That's a three ball, too. 23-21. Harris is a freshman from Suffolk, Virginia. Only a freshman.
Not afraid to shoot right off the bench. My goodness.
Dommy looking for help. Ball is taken away. Harris has it underneath. Here she goes. In there. That'll be a three-point play, too, if she converts. Harris gives her team some spark right there and ties the game at 23. Mariah Smith in the game, and Dommy sits down. .337 left in the first half. Harris hits. Puts the Wildcats back on top by one. 22, White back in the game. She replaces Jones. Got to pick up that intensity again before that timeout. It really got intense. Now they switched off. Change defenses here on Fields. Puts it up off the glass, no good. One and done there. And Bethune-Cookman coming the other way. Let's try to pick up the new defense Bethune-Cookman is doing, Todd, since the timeout.
Yeah, Harris is really giving them a lift here. And she turns it over with a travel.
Traveling violation on Harris, I believe, right? I believe that was. Now they've taken Golden off of Fields. And now Harris is guarding Fields. See how this works out. A switching man-to-man, maybe? Cook throws it up, goes out of bounds. We'll see if they've slapped it away, but no, they give it back to Bethune-Cookman.
Yeah, she's grabbing her right arm as if she was fouling the way up.
.246, Wildcats up by one. Harris looking inside. Gets it to Scott. Scott, 10-foot jump shot, no good. Graham has it, lost it. Now Bethune-Cookman has it again. Shot, no good.
Yeah, Price blocked it.
Coppin will get it. .223. And here comes Brooke. Once again, Harris meets her. Does a head fake. Under a nice pass by Brooke to Smith. What a great assist that was. Great assist by Brooke to Smith to put Coppin State back on top by one.
Nice baseline run.
We're at the two-minute mark. Ball taken away by Price. She's one-on-one. Cameron Smith takes it away, though. A little bit too much there. Here's a three-point play. No good. Harris with the rebound between two defenders. Puts it up off the glass. No good. Battle for the rebound. And Coppin State has it. Nice hustle there by Coleman. Fields. A bounce pass to Coleman. She'll shoot a 25-footer. No good. Underneath. Ball goes back to Bethune-Cookman.
Minute. I believe they're saying that Smith knocked it off the body of Harrison out of bounds.
They do. They reverse it. Ball goes back to the Eagles. Bounce pass inside to Smith. She drifts back to the right corner on top to Price. Price swings left. Three ball on the way. No good by Fields. 1:21 left. Coppin up by one. Angel Golden comes down, gives the ball back out front to Harris. And Harris is pretty much directing the team by now.
Yeah, they've now moved, as you mentioned, Golden over the two.
Underneath a foul. White was fouled. Let's see who they call it on. On Price. Amaya Price picks up the foul. That's her first, team's fourth. Tania White will shoot two. With the chance to put the Wildcats back on top. First shot good. We're tied at 25. So far, Angel Golden and Brooke Fields have played the entire game. Second shot is good. Bethune-Cookman on top by one. Price comes out, and Adrian Dart in the game.
This should be interesting because Chaz Brown's drawing her defensively.
1 minute.
We're at 1 minute. Fields gets a screen.
Yeah, it's a moving screen, too.
Yep, sure was.
You have to plant. Right on the screen. You have to set the feet, because if you don't, the official most of the time calls it as an illegal moving screen.
26-25. Bethune-Cookman on top. Slapped inside. Angel Golden has it. She's going to shoot a three. In and out. No good. Let's see who has it. Battle for it.
They say Darden stepped out of bounds with the rebound.
Comes inside to Golden. She's double-teamed quickly. Palm ball. You don't see that one very often. 35.6 seconds in the first half. Fields surveys the situation left and right. And Harris is there to meet her. How will they play this one, Todd? 18 on the shot clock. Fields drives. Puts it up. No good. Air ball. The Wildcats are running. 14 seconds. Harris has it. Looks to her left. Ball's almost taken away by Fields. They find underneath. They find Brown. Loose. No good. Second try. Up and in. As time runs out. Right at the buzzer. Time ran out in the first half as Brown puts it in. Halftime, Bethune-Cookman 28, Coppin State 25, and you're listening to the Coppin State Sport Network as Coach Burroughs joins Todd.
Dan, thank you very kindly, and Coach Burroughs once again joining us here at the break. Coach, we just saw the last 30 seconds play out not the way you wanted it to.
Definitely not the way we wanted it to. We gambling on the defensive end of the floor instead of playing honest defense. We played honest defense for 19 minutes, and we want to cheat the last 30 seconds of the half, and they get two easy buckets.
Smith's got a great first half going with 7 points.
Yeah, not bad at all. I mean, we just got to keep her going and get everybody else going as well. I just think in the second half, when Chance gets going and Brooke gets going, we'll be okay.
Appreciate the time. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
There is head coach Dwayne Burroughs trailing 28-25 at the break. And as Dan mentioned a moment ago, this is the Cobb State Sports Network.
Gentlemen, thank you very much for playing our half-court three-point free throw layup contest by CSU Athletics. Time now for our Coppin State layup contest brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings at Owings Mills, Rundle Mills, and White March. We have Anijah Addison and Jonathan Mendoza. And they have to get dressed in a Coppin State basketball uniform and make a layup. And the winning contestant will receive a $25 Buffalo Wild Wings gift card. All right, gentlemen, are you ready? Get set, go!
Mommy shark, do-do-do-do-do, mommy shark, do-do-do-do-do, mommy shark, do-do-do-do-do, mommy shark.
Daddy shark, do-do-do-do-do, daddy shark, do-do-do-do-do, daddy shark, do-do-do-do-do, daddy shark.
Grandma shark, do-do-do-do-do, grandma shark, do-do-do-do-do, grandma shark, do-do-do-do-do.
All right, we got a winner. Congratulations. All right, thank you for playing our layup contest brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings. Hey, the big game is here, and it means it's time to get our big game party orders in. Call B-Dubs today and reserve your time for pickup. Don't forget to ask about our party menu. And if you pre-order this week and pick up before 3 p.m. on Sunday, February 3rd, you'll get 10% off. Buffalo Wild Wings, Arundel Mills, Owings Mills, and White Marsh, Maryland.
People ask me why I love Blazer Rewards so much. I mean, isn't it obvious? You earn points by hanging out with friends and eating wings and watching sports. And I mean all the sports, like football, baseball, basketball, pop, pop, soccer, karate, boxing, Vincent. This one, I don't know. Check it out. First, you join. Go to blazingrewards.com and follow the simple steps to sign up. Second, you earn. Just get off your butt and head to B-Dubs. Earn points by checking in, bringing friends, and ordering food. And finally, you redeem. Turn those hard-earned points into awesome rewards like wings, drinks, shareables, and more. Then just write your phone number on the check and rewards are deducted from your total. You can even earn points watching LARPing.
LARPing. LARPing.
Don't forget to stay social with your favorite conference. Search MEAC Sports on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and also on YouTube for day-to-day updates on everything MEAC. Also, use the hashtags IBackTheMEAC and MEAC Nation to see your posts reposted. From the moment you enter the newly renovated Holiday Inn, Baltimore Inner Harbor, until you return home, you experience all the charms that give our hometown its Charm City moniker. Hotels conveniently located 3 blocks from Baltimore Inner Harbor attractions and is right across from the Baltimore Convention Center. Within 1 mile, guests can find the Horseshoe Casino, the Hard Rock Cafe, M&T Bank Stadium, home of your Baltimore Ravens. THB Bagels and Deli in Charles Village, proud sponsor of Coppin State basketball. Come and enjoy Baltimore's hometown bagels made fresh daily. Don't forget to become a member of the Coppin State Alumni Association. Become a member today at the registration table on the concourse. And get your kids ready for summer by registering for basketball and tennis camps at coppincamps.com. Fun, fun, and more fun, coppincamps.com.
The dance starts here. The 2019 MEAC Basketball Tournament is back at Scope Arena in Norfolk, Virginia. It's 6 days of nonstop action as your favorite MEAC men's and women's basketball teams battle it out on the court for the right to play in the big dance. Get your tickets today at MEACHoops.com. Member institutions and Ticketmaster. March 11th through the 16th at Scope Arena as the road to the big dance goes through Norfolk.
28-25, Bethune-Cookman with the advantage over Coppin State. And Dan, Coppin had a lead of 23-18, and then Bethune-Cookman closed out the half 10-2.
Well, the last 30 seconds, like Coach Burrow said, I think the defense got a little bit away from him. But I'm really interested, Todd, to see what happens in the matchup with Angel Golden and Brooke Fields. Now, they made a defensive switch and put took Golden off of Angel. I'm not Angel, but let's move ahead here. Let's look at the head-to-head. 41% shooting for Coppin State, which is really good for them. That's way above their 30% average, and not so good for Bethune-Cookman. 100% free throw shooting. Not that they only had three shots from the line. And Bethune-Cookman typically is a 65% free throw shooting team, but they didn't quite make it there. And you know, 3-point shooting, it's tough for both teams. And like we talked during the halftime, the less threes they take, happier man I am.
Yeah, neither team shooting well at all from three. Three makes on 13 attempts for Bethune-Cookman, 2 of 9 for Coppin. So they're being selective, but Brooke Fields not getting going yet from deep like she did on Saturday, just 1 of 5.
I'm really anxious to see how they defend Brooke Fields coming out. Who will they play on her? Will they put Angel Golden back on her, or will they put Kemmery Harris back on her? So let's see how they play that.
And how about Harris?
Did a great job.
6 immediate points after entering the game, and then the 3-point lead at the half. She's arguably the difference.
That is a freshman with no fear. Did a great job in the first half.
By the way, we also, to make a note of this, as you see the basketballs exiting to our stage left, they changed basketballs about 4 minutes in. The first game ball they used was half flat, according to the official.
Well, that's interesting.
And then they changed it out.
Sounds like a Tom Brady move.
Yeah.
Coppin breaks huddle, waiting on the Wildcats, and here they come. The Wildcats decked out in that black uniform and blood maroon and Florida Sun Gold. Love the way they talk like that. Smith inbounds the Fields, and sure enough, Kemmery Harris is right there to meet her. Deep to Sally. And a whistle already.
Yes, yeah, somebody got held coming around the screen.
This one's going to go against Amaya Scott. Her second foul.
Foul call number 2, Amaya Scott, her second first team foul.
Field brings it in underneath her own basket. Smith gets it to Fields, and she is heavily guarded by Harris. Chance falls down, it goes out of bounds. I don't think she was pushed, she just fell.
Yeah, I don't know if it's the floor, if she hit a spot, or what that was.
So here comes Harris, who had that good first half. Golden in the right corner. First shot of the game by the Wildcats. First shot of the second half, I should say, by the Wildcats. Nothing there.
And Chaz Brown with the rim and off.
Looking inside, bounces into Sally. She's going to go for that basket. No good. Bethune-Cookman with the rebound. Harris is quick. She gets it up quickly to Angel Golden. Back out front. Scott drives around two defenders. No good. Bethune-Cookman with the second try, and Brown puts it in. 30-25. That's the longest Bethune-Cookman lead of the night.
12-2 run after Coppin was up by 5.
Fields to Smith. She pushes the ball over to Fields on the left side. Mariah's going to shoot a 3. No good. Wildcats running. Here comes Golden. Underneath. Laid in by Ball. Coach Burrows wants a timeout. 8:14 left in the third quarter. Bethune-Cookman 32, Coppin State 25. You're listening to the Coppin State Sports Network.
out of the Coppin call timeout. Fans, you can listen to all Coppin State basketball home games on FoxSportsWilliamsport.com, as well as Baltimore's WNST 1570 AM. Proud partners of Coppin State Athletics. Todd Bartley, Dan Mason with you. 32-25, Bethune-Cookman with a 14-2 run after Coppin led by five.
Longest lead of the night at seven. Pressure comes from the Wildcats. Broken easily by Coppin State. Here's Fields, drives the lane, is blocked. Sally with the rebound, up, no good. Rebound to the Eagles, and they have it. Fields backs off. Gets a fresh shot clock. Gets a screen, can't take that. Now Golden is back on Fields. Mariah shoots a three, no good. Ball skips out of bounds, and Bethune-Cookman will take it back. Substitution. First time we've seen Corby tonight. She replaces Mariah Smith. Coach is not happy with that. Mariah shot that ball. She didn't hit it. She's 0 for 4 from the three-point line tonight, or three-point perimeter. Inside, the Wildcats have it underneath. Ball thrown away.
Push, push.
Corby gets it, and Fields has it. Coach Burroughs yells, push, push, push. And Fields does that, and she's fouled.
Harris with the foul. That's her first.
Harris picks it up. Coppin State will inbound under their own basket. 7:26 in the third quarter. Graham has it out front to the right with Fields. Now Harris is back on her in the corner. A good ball movement. Graham has it, drives the basket, puts it up, no good. Second chance by Fields, and she's trying to make that Sally, and she's fouled. This one goes on Ball. That's Ball's first foul, and sends Sally to the line. First time tonight from the free throw stripe for Sally. No good. Not close that time, Todd.
I think she tried to overshoot it, if you will, Dan, to try to adjust. It just deviated to the left.
Ball almost wedged in the left corner. Second shot in the air. This one's no good either. Coppin with the rebound. A battle on the floor. Picked up by the Wildcats. Harris in control. Gets it off to Golden. Out front. Nice play by Scott. She drove the left-hand side of the lane and laid it in. Bethune-Cookman 34, Coppin 25. That is the longest lead of the night. Ball taken away by the Wildcats. Harris has it. Bounce pass, no good. Off the glass, and there's a foul underneath. This one's going to be on Graham. That's her chance. Second foul.
Yeah, and then they pulled Amaya Scott away as she took exception to the foul by Chance Graham.
Scott at the free throw line, getting two shots. First one on the way. It's good. 100. Defensive intensity has to pick up a little bit now.
Yeah, Coppin needs some easy baskets right now because everything is laborious on the offensive end.
Scott with the second shot. Good. 11-point lead. 6:36 left. Fields has it. Needs some offense here. Corby on the right. Underneath. Chance steps on the inbound stripe. Another turnover.
18-2 run for Bethune-Cookman and 12 unanswered.
Here comes the freshman, Harris. Here's Angel Golden for three. Bingo. She's got it. Angel Golden fires away, and she hits it and takes her lead to 14 points. Coach Burroughs wants timeout. So there's timeout on the floor. Bethune Cookman 39, Coppin State 25. You're listening to the Coppin State Sports Network.
Fans High Place Baltimore Inner Harbor, located near Fells Point, offers a refreshing blend of style and innovation in a neighborhood alive with cultural attractions, shopping, and amazing local restaurants. High Place Baltimore Inner Harbor, the official downtown hotel of Coppin State Athletics. And 15 unanswered right now by the Wildcats after Coppin had a lead of 5, and now 21-2 is that overall run.
Wildcats have come out on fire, and they are pressing full court. Ball floated across. Now to Fields. Doesn't take the shot. To Dami, back to Fields on the left wing. Now she'll go inside. Off the glass, can't hit that shot. Taken down by the Wildcats. They're on the run again with Harris. Harris with three defenders. Spins around. Ball goes out of bounds, and it's going to go back to... Well, let's see. I believe they're offensive foul here.
Amani Ball with a foul. That's her second.
Yep. Two personals on Ball now. And Maya Price in the game, and Dami sits down. Need a little run here, Todd. 14-point lead. And gosh, did that go quickly.
Even a 6-2 answer. Something. 11-0 in the quarter in favor of Bethune-Cookman.
Moving in on the five-minute mark now in the third quarter. Corby, a long shot. Got it. Bingo. Bango. And Corby's got it. Three-point play. 39-28. Angel Golden inside. Spin move on Sally. No good. Price with a rebound. Fields is on the run. She drives the paint all the way. Shot's blocked. We'll get a foul.
Well, something came loose. There's debris on the floor.
This is on Angel Golden. That's her second. Fields goes to the line. Believe it or not, this is Brooks' first free throw tonight. In the air, it's good.
Oh, it was the whistle. Baseline official had the whistle come apart. Came off the lanyard.
Brooke gets a second. 39-30. 5-18. Coppin's going to press of their own now. Inbound to Golden. To Harris. Ball's taken away. And I believe that Price came down on the sideline. That's a tough break. Made a nice play there. But landed on the sideline. So they're going to give it back to the Wildcats.
Yeah, they're double-checking the shot clock, too. I believe they're going to run it down to 24.
Correct you are, Todd. Here comes Harris. The ball. Inside to Scott. Here's a long three ball on the way. Good by Ball. She was left all alone there. And she let it fly. 42-30. Eagles within 12. Ball slapped up by Sally. She went up for it and then went against the backboard. And the Wildcats have it. Here comes Golden with another three. This one doesn't go. Graham with the rebound to Price. The Fields. 4:30 in the third quarter. Still manageable. 12-point lead. underneath. Corby lays it up the glass. Good. Nice assist from Fields that time. Beautiful pass. Got her on the run, and she put it up and in.
Sahai replacing Smith, who exited with 7 points. Now Corby, a quick five here in the third.
Brown all the way up off the glass. Traded baskets that time. Scott put it in. .357 12-point lead. Field spins. Let's see if there's a whistle we get here. Be a Wildcat foul. This one's on Harris. Her second foul. We'll send Brooke Fields back to the line. And probably here the Wildcats. That's the last person you'd want to put on the line, Todd.
Very good free throw shooter on the year. That shows why right there.
Brooke is a 78% free throw shooter. Second one bounces out. Sally with the rebound. We'll go again. Corby sees some daylight. Doesn't take it, but Graham will shoot a three. No good. Wildcats clear. They're up by 11. 3:41 to go. Third quarter. Scott inside. Ball slapped away. Turnover. And Coppin State has it. Here comes Brooke. Calling a play. Looks inside to Sally. Can't get any movement. Doesn't go there. Does a head fake. She'll go to the basket. Foul inside. This one's going to be on Harris. Two-shot foul. And now Brooke goes to the free throw line. Harris has three fouls. You see a little life there with Coppin State. They're clawing back. First shot by Brooke. No good. Uncharacteristic by that. Walker back in the game, and now Harris will sit down. Three fouls, she goes to the bench.
Yeah, and those 6 points nearly in a row in the second quarter.
Second shot by Fields is good. Cuts a lead to 10. And that full court press is back.
Yeah. Stay.
Scott takes it across the center line. Angel Golden in the corner. Back out front to Walker. Walker looks inside. The Golden on the right. Shovels it back out. Underneath now. Blocked by Sally, but they're going to call her for a foul. Hard to tell if that was a clean block from our angle.
Well, there's a big elongated step to get to that doorstep first, damn it. Coach Burrow's one of the travel calls. I think he's got a case there.
So that's three on Jalinda Sally. First shot by Brown is good. 9 points on the night by Brown. 45-34. Second shot, no good. Eagles clear, and Corby on the run. Graham to Fields in the right, working the right wing. She does a head fake, wants to drive the basket. Here she goes, she's fouled. I believe this one will be on Walker. Yes, it is. A push by Walker, and it sends Brooke back to the free throw line for two.
Now, Dan, this does two things with Brooke taking it strong to the basket. You're on that kind of contact. You're racking up fouls against the opponent. It also gives you an opportunity to put points on the board with time stopped.
This is exactly the strategy, Todd. They're going to keep going right back to this play. Brooke is going to drive that lane most every time, and if they're fortunate enough to dish it off to Graham, they'll do it. Second shot's no good. Graham with the rebound, puts it up and in. So there you go. 45-37, 8-point lead, 2:41 left in the third quarter.
Unconventional 3-point play, but we'll take it.
Here's Walker underneath the basket, lays it in. She was pretty much uncontested that time. Oloyede up off the bench, getting ready to check in. 2:21. Down by 10. Fields. Graham's going to shoot a three. No good. Corby with a rebound. Let's get a new shot clock. Got to keep the strategy going to drive the paint. Fields looks inside. Here she goes again to the center. Sally underneath. No good. Bounce out on her. She had a clean shot at that one. Couldn't fall. A minute 50. 47-37. Angel Golden does a head fake around Graham. Does a floater. No good. Battle for the rebound. Underneath, Sally has it. It's going to be a jump ball. Possession arrow, Coppin State. 10-point lead by the Wildcats. And here comes Dami. She's in for Sally. Only a minute 40 in the third quarter. Wildcat substitution, Fincher. We'll check in. We'll wave her in now. And she is going to replace Brown. Here we go. Wildcats take it in. Get it inside. It goes right into Price's hands, and they've got it. Eagles have it. A minute 34. Down by 10. Fields drives the lane with a blocking foul. This one's going to go on Walker. And once again, Brooke goes right back to the free throw stripe.
Yeah, Walker stuck her nose in there defensively, and Brooke gave her plenty of shoulder.
They call the blocking foul on Walker. Brooks back to the line. Her shot in the air, good.
All six of her third quarter points at the free throw line.
The senior from Owings Mill, Maryland. Only 5'6", hits the second one. The lead's at 8. Here comes Scott. Long three, no good by Golden. Bounces out of bounds, and they give it back to the Wildcats. 1:18 left now.
It is a chance, got a hand on it. There's a look at head coach Vanessa Blair Lewis.
Come back to the corner, bro. Coming back to the corner. Here he comes.
Ball comes into Golden. Corby takes it away. Dishes it off to Dami. Price waits for the ball to set up. Now gives it to Fields, and she'll set it up. Down to 1 minute. Positions Chance. She wants Chance under the board, most likely. 12 on the shot clock. Ball inside to Graham. She's going to spin. Puts it up off the glass. Good. Chance Graham puts it up and in. Well, we got a whistle. What's this one about?
I believe it was a delay of game as she hit the ball after it went through the basket. I don't believe she got credited with a foul.
47, 41, 44 seconds left. Double teamed out front. Walker's double team. Gets the ball off the Fincher. Angel Golden's going to shoot a three. No good. Corby with the rebound. 32 seconds and a 6-point deficit. Fields. Todd, you think she's going to drive for the bucket?
Sahai wants the ball in the right corner. So watch Corby backdoor along the baseline late in the shot clock.
18 seconds, 13 on the shot clock. Tries to get around Walker. She's going to drive the bucket. Here she goes. No good. Dami with a rebound. And I believe we're going to get an offensive foul here. Yep, Dami committed the foul. So they call Dami for the foul, and the Wildcats will inbound. Golden with only 10 seconds. She's on the move. She's going to get it out. A three ball in the right corner by Fincher is no good. Only 4 seconds, and Graham's got to run. Ball is blocked. It goes out of bounds as time runs out. Time runs out in the third quarter. Bethune-Cookman 47, Coppin State 41. You're listening to the Coppin State Sports Network.
fans from the moment you enter the newly renovated Holiday Inn, Baltimore Inner Harbor, until you return home, you experience the charms that give our hometown its Charm City moniker. Hotels can be located 3 blocks from Baltimore's Inner Harbor attractions, across from the Baltimore Convention Center. Within a mile, guests can find the Horseshoe Casino, Hard Rock Cafe, M&T Bank Stadium, the home of the Baltimore Ravens.
Well, a slow start in the beginning of the third quarter, but Coppin State came on in the end, down by six. Ball comes in play. Corby has it out front on the right wing. Drives around Harris. Crisscross pass to Price out front. Here goes Steele. She's going to go to the basket. Up off the glass and good. It can't stop her, Todd. When she gets up loose under that basket, she's going to score.
She gets 16.
Ball deflected. It goes in the stands and the Wildcats will get it back. Good defensive play by Price that time.
Chance Graham almost on a double-double. 9 points, 11 boards through three.
Keep that defensive effort up. 47-43. Harris with the ball. One-on-one. Looking inside. Gets it to Golden. Harris, top of the perimeter. Golden inside. Spin, no good. Off the side of the backboard. Now a foul. Goes against Price. A two-shot foul this time coming from Brown.
Shot clock was at three when they called that foul.
Chaz Brown is a physical player. She is really strong. Her shot rims in. Bounces in there for her.
Double figures now with 10.
Second shot's good. The lead's back to six, 49-43. Corby hands it off the field. Here comes Corby for three. Hits the side of the backboard. Harris on the move. Critical time right now, Todd. Stay in this game and be intense. Golden. With Graham on her. Pincher moves closer to the basket. Airballs it right over the top. Corby looking inside. Goes back out front. Fields. Tries to look inside. Graham bags it. Graham with a field goal. 49-45. Running up on the eight-minute mark.
Graham that field goal now with her 12th double-double and a timeout at half court.
Harris was teamed, a double-team there. But quickly, Vanessa Blair-Lewis calls timeout. So we've got a timeout with 8:04. Bethune-Cookman 49, Coppin State 45. You're listening to the Coppin State Sports Network.
Time getting his four-year degree, preparing for a lucrative career. Kimberly took time off to start a family and now attends Coppin part-time and enjoys the affordability and supportive environment. Kazim wants to change careers and finds that Coppin provides the flexibility he needs to keep working while getting that second degree. Coppin State University, something different to everyone, something special for you.
Checking out the MEAC scoreboard on a Monday night. Maryland Eastern Shore leads at Howard by 7, fourth quarter, 80-73. North Carolina Central in a low-scoring battle at Savannah State, 43-37. And Morgan at home leading FAMU 42-31 in the fourth quarter. Here, fourth quarter, four-point margin in favor of Bethune-Cookman, 49-45. Here is Dan Mason.
Well, you know, Morgan State would like to get a game back tonight, especially after that loss to Bethune-Cookman Saturday. Bethune-Cookman 49, Coppin State 45. Amaya Scott will put it in play. Into Harris. Harris has had a great game tonight. Pincher inside to Brown. Nice defensive play by Dami as she swats it away.
14, that's all it is. 12 Wait. Seconds, guys, get a stop.
Only 12 get seconds on the shot clock. Harris finally comes over and picks up the ball to throw it in. Looks for someone. Finally gets it in. Underneath, Pincher, no good. Dami with a rebound. And here comes Brooke. Looks inside. Here she goes. Underneath. Up and in. Brooke put it in.
Make it
to Dami. Going the other way. No good. Chance clears the rebound. And here comes Brooke Fields again. Behind the back. Gets it inside to Graham. She lays it up off the glass. No good. Gets the rebound and she's fouled. Good second effort that time by Chance Graham.
Well, Dan, she was fouled twice on the same trip to the floor.
Foul on 23 for
this one's on Fincher. That's her first. So Chance at the line for two. In the air, good. 12th point of the night by Chance. 49-48. Cobbin down by only one. Two bounces on the floor. Second shot, good. We're tied at 49. And the pressure comes. Harris inside. Angel Golden with Price on her. Floats it inside. Almost thrown away, but Harris gets it deep in the left corner. To Scott. Now it goes inside to Brown. Angel Golden, long three, and she nailed it.
3.4.
Go back to Angel Golden, who puts her team up by three. Now Fields looks inside. She's going to go to the paint. Here she goes. Up, no good. Didn't make it that time. Brown picks it up and quickly to Walker. Walker to Golden. Golden drives. This time up off the glass and good. She's going to get the and one.
And goodbye, Angel Golden.
Angel Golden speared through the paint. That's on Dami. Fourth foul on Dami.
So Coppin ripped off a 25-10 run to even the game at 49. And they've given up six unanswered.
Angel Golden, an 86% free throw shooter. Got it. Brooke is fouled. This will be on Brown. Walker. Make it Walker. That's her third. Brooke Fields will take it out underneath her own basket. Inbound to Price. 6:22. Fields wants to shoot that three, but doesn't. Corby has it deep. She'll pop a three. In the air. No good. Wildcats clear. She was open. That was a decent shot. Couldn't make it, though. Going the other way. Underneath. Laid in by Brown. Chaz Brown muscled her way right through there and put it in. The lead's at 8, 5:46 left. Fields looks, gets it to Corby. Now Corby drives the paint. Back to Graham. She's open at 10 feet. No good. Wildcats have it, and they're on the run. Chance was wide open that time. Nobody close. Angel Golden, 25 feet. No good. Ball skips out of bounds. It goes to Coppin State. Colvin now comes in the game, and Corby comes out. 5:26 left. Bethune Cookman 57 and Coppin 49. Fields against Walker. Bounce pass. Dami up and oh, missed it. Just bounced out on her. But she'll draw the foul.
Who's foul on, sir?
Foul on 12.
So it's Chaz Brown's foul goes second personal.
Only two on Brown. Tommy missed the first. Second one's in the air. Short. 5-14. 57-49. Wildcats on top. Into Brown. She spins and she traveled.
So ahead of the media timeout, they must make possession down by 8.
5-07. Fields between two defenders. Couldn't get there. Came up short there. Here comes Golden. Bounce pass to Brown. Underneath. And we'll pick up a foul underneath on Coppin State.
Yeah, Harris helped back up off the floor, shaking up a bit.
Foul's going to go against Chance Graham.
That's her third, and at 4:55 to go, it brings us to the under 5 media timeout. And they'll also take a look at the monitor to see if anything else happened on that last play.
We'll check back. So with the media timeout, Bethune-Cookman 57, Coppin State 49. You are listening to the Coppin State Sports Network.
Using the foul called. Last Eagle foul called.
Pretty significant conversation between the officials. They've gone to the video replay. Chance Graham's assessed her third personal foul. And anytime the conversation goes this long, you'd have to think they're discussing a flagrant type of foul.
Both coaches now come to center court amongst the two officials.
Yeah, and Dwayne Burroughs' reaction here on our live video stream is going to tell the story. If it indeed has been ruled a flagrant foul on Chance Graham.
I thought Chance was going for the ball, though. I mean, I've watched it several times.
Yeah, this is quite the proceeding because neither coach right now looks happy at all. And this is a huge call in an 8-point game with under 5 to go. Coppin's down to 2 timeouts remaining. The media timeouts are over, as far as we can tell. Bethune-Cookman down to 3 timeouts remaining.
The only thing I can tell is Coach Burroughs said, don't let it get out of hand.
Yeah, and neither coach is real happy with that whole conversation.
All I'm saying is, don't let this get out of hand. I am not going to let my kids be pushed around.
So that's what they call it. It's unsportsmanlike conduct. So there's going to be 2 shots, and then the ball is awarded to Bethune-Cookman after the 2 shots.
And again, Chance remains, I believe, at three personal fouls.
Correct. That was like a similar call we saw a few weeks ago that went against Coppin State.
And Chance, preseason All-MEAC selection, is not happy. Harris knocks down that free throw, Dan.
It's the first.
Nine unanswered.
Harris has been a cool customer tonight, Todd, that's for sure.
So now 25-10, Coppin to get it even at 49. And now 10 unanswered by Bethune-Cookman. It's like the run never happened.
Price back in the game, and Sally goes to the bench. Just under 5 minutes left. Still time for another run. Brown against Graham. And a foul. This one's going to go against Chance.
You kidding me? The defense is a four.
That's her fourth.
You got four.
Yeah, now Brian's having a conversation with the official that made that call, and they're trying to sort it out to make sure that's not her fifth.
Foul call on 23, Chance Graham. That's her fourth personal. 14 foul.
It's the fourth Coppin foul, so it's non-shooting.
Harris will throw it in. Sees Brown, doesn't go there. Now they get it to Brown for 10 feet. Good. Chance Brown's played a whale of a game tonight, too. 61-49. Graham has it out front. She's going to drive the paint. Underneath, blocked out of bounds. No call. Chance was pleading her case, but doesn't get the call. Here's Price. She dishes it off to Fields. Deep in the right corner, now the right wing, inside to Chance. Chance is going to go again. Up off the glass, she'll get the call this time, though.
Yes, she went right in the body of Amaya Scott. Picks up her third.
It's almost like she was destined for that one.
Foul call number two, Amaya Scott. That's her third personal, 14 foul. For the Lady Eagles, on 23.
Chance is still not happy, even after she got the call. She's not quite sure what she's complaining about right now, but
well, she tried to ask him a question. Coach Burrow said, "You go shoot the free throw. I'll handle the conversation."
There you go. First shot's good. 61-50, 4:16 left. Second shot, no good. Here come the Wildcats. Harris is one-on-one against Smith. Dished off to Scott. Scott way out front. Gets a screen from Brown. Spins. Puts it up. No good. Graham with the rebound. Fields pushes the ball up court. She's going to drive the center of the paint. Here she goes. Up off the glass. No good. Graham with the rebound, and she's fouled. That was on Harris. That's her fourth.
This is the game plan again. 3:46 to go. Get to the line.
The two best free throw shooters have been at the line. First shot good. 10-point lead, 61-51. 3:46 now. Second shot good. Cut that lead to nine. Mild pressure from Brooke Fields. Old Brown is underneath by herself, and she's bumped. Price fouls her.
It's her third.
Sends Chaz Brown back to the line. Brown is only a 62% free throw shooter, but she's hit some tonight. First one bounced off. How about Angel Golden and Brooke Fields? Played the whole game tonight. Second one's no good. Coleman snatches the rebound away. 3:30. Pushes it over to Fields. Working that right wing. Now she's against Golden. Up, no good. Couldn't get the shot up. And she puts it in, and Golden fouled her. Brooke put it in off the glass, and Angel Golden slapped her on the wrist and went right in. I bet you Angel Golden's not happy with that defensive move.
But no, Brooke gave her that real strong head fake to get her off her feet.
In there for the three-point play. Six-point lead. And the pressure comes. Scott has it. She's against Coleman. Scott's going to drive the basket. Up, off the glass, no good. Hits the side of the board. Puts a second chance up, and there's a foul. This one's on Coleman. That's her third foul.
Foul call number three, Kaya Coleman. That's her first personal.
Close to the three-minute mark now.
Number two, Amaya Scott.
Amaya Scott at 61% free throw shooter. The sophomore from Sunrise, Florida. No good. Eagles are hanging around, Scott, or rather Todd, hanging around. Second shot. This one's good. Make it a 7-point lead. Coleman hands off to Fields. She's got Walker on her. Brooke out front. Drives. Make it 2 points by Smith. Nice shot there by Maya. No good by Harris, but it's put in by Brown. Harris was out of control that time, but Brown picked it up off the floor and put it in. Foul was on Fields. That's two fouls on Brooke. Brown missed a shot. 2:30 now. A 7-point lead. Smith drives again. She's fouled.
Foul call number 12, Jazz Brown. Her third person.
Jazz Brown picks up another.
Ryan Smith at the line. Two shots for the Eagles.
That's three on Jazz Brown. Smith at the line. First one's no good. Tommy's in, Coleman's out. Mariah is typically a good free throw shooter, Todd. 71% for the year.
Looking for double figures here tonight.
Second one in the air, good. The lead is at 6. 2:25. That's all that's left. Here comes Harris. Defense is spread well right now. Harris trying to get something inside. Ball taken away by Graham. A scramble for it on the floor. The ball goes out of bounds. They'll probably give it back to the Wildcats. We'll see where it goes. Well, there's some confusion here, but I believe the Wildcats will retain possession.
13 to shoot. They still got to come the length of the floor.
Ball's inbound. Here comes Walker. Walker with 10 on the shot clock. Golden has it. 6 on the shot clock. Scott, 15-foot jumper, no good. Smith with the rebound. She runs the floor. Wildcats are back. Ball's in the air. It's good. Control with the right hand side of the basket. Put it up off the glass, and she is fouled.
Foul call on the drive on Ryan Walker, who fourth person.
Foul is on Walker.
Mariah Smith.
And that's four on Walker. Mariah Smith has a chance to cut that lead to three. In the air. Good. Only a minute 50. Coppin down by three. Harris with four fouls. Walker with four fouls. Underneath, Harris puts it in. She got loose that time and laid it in.
Yeah, Dan, you can't give her penetration that deep to the basket.
Here's Fields. Up off the glass and good. Right back at you that time. 66-63. 1:23 left. Baseball pass to Harris. Coppin's back. A minute 13. Harris with Smith on her out front. 16 on the shot clock. The freshman drives the basket, flips it back out to Golden. Angel Golden shoots.
And we've blocking got a foul. Foul or moving screen is the question.
Fouls on Price. Sends Angel Golden to the line. Price has four fouls now. Well, they pull Angel Golden out, and they put Brown on the free throw line for two. If you look at the numbers, that's probably good because Angel Golden is 86%. Brown misses the first.
Coppin's got to get this rebound, Dan. Down three with a minute three to go.
Not much time left, Todd. You're exactly right. Second shot by Brown. Bounces in. Pressure comes from Scott. 1 minute. Fields has it. She tries to drive. She's going to go against Harris. Puts it up off the glass. No good. Dommy with the rebound. Back to Smith. Smith out front now to Price. Fresh shot clock. Smith is going to drive the baseline. Dishes it off. Dommy has it. Loses it to the Wildcats. They have it. Ball bounces out of bounds. It's going to go back to Coppin. Yes, sir.
How about Walker lost it as Coach Burrows was chasing the official down the sideline. And then Walker inexplicably lost it out of bounds. And we got a timeout on the floor, I believe, taken by Coppin.
That's right. We'll leave it right here. 67-63. There's only 38 seconds left. What's your strategy, Todd?
Well, the question's going to be, first of all, are they going to review this? Yes, they are. They're going to go to the monitor, Dan, first of all, to see where the ball went in or out of bounds and if there was contact here on this sideline.
I do believe it went off Bethune Cookman. It was off Walker.
Now, to answer your question, down by four. You're looking for the quick drive to the basket, a potential and one, again, to cut this to a one-possession margin. And you're looking to go 2-1 on the other end. So if you can get the made field goal, right, and or a free throw. And ball, the ball went off.
Yeah, it absolutely went off of Walker. I think you lost concentration there coming up. So where do you inbound that now with your Coppin?
Here's an issue we may have. I think they're going to have a conversation with Coach Burrows because if you look at the stripe.
Him being out of the stripe?
Yeah.
That is a problem. How do they call that? Technical foul?
And they didn't call it during live action either. So do you give a bench warning? Yeah, and then the question is, does he want the timeout? He does get the timeout as the ball went out of bounds. And the clock will stay at 38.9. And then he said to both coaches, y'all want to stay behind those lines, please?
Well, here comes Angel Golden. She'll throw her hands up in Smith's face as she tries to inbound. Got to get that ball inbound. She's having trouble. Gets it to Dommy, or rather to Price, finally. 37 seconds left. Not a lot of time. Price gets it to Smith. Need to get that ball into Brookfield's hands. They finally do. 27 seconds now. Brook, long shot. No good. Way off. Wildcats have it. Got a foul here. Quickly, we get to the Angel Golden now. Only 17 seconds on now. And there's a foul. 15 seconds on the clock. 67-63. Fouls on Fields, and that is her third. Angel Golden goes to the line with only 15 seconds left. And she doesn't miss much. That one bounces in. 68-63. Second shot, good. 69-63. Timeout Coppin State.
That will also advance the ball to the forecourt, Dan.
21 points tonight by Brooke Fields, 16 tonight by Chance Graham. Even scoring pretty much by Bethune Cookman.
So strategically, you're looking for, of course, the inbound here. Quick slip for a three. Potentially Fields, potentially Smith. Chance can step back as well. So let's see if they go for three here quickly and then an immediate foul. Anybody other than Angel Golden. See if Smith gets it back after being an inbounder. And again, Golden will defend.
Team seconds left. And you got to get a quick shot of that basket. Fields shoots out of the corner, a three ball. No good. Wildcats have it. And a quick foul.
Mariah with her first at 10.7 to go.
Foul number two, Mariah Smith, her second personal.
69-63, 10.7 left. This time, Brown will go to the free throw line.
If Coppin does end up falling today, they did all that work to get back even at 49, and then Bethune-Cookman, an answer of 12-0, arguably decides the game.
Brown's first shot, no good. Brown's a leading rebounder for this team. Second shot, no good. Another timeout by Coppin State. So with 10 seconds left,
that was at 10.7 a moment ago. It's at 10.1 on a rebound.
Does seem odd.
Yeah. More than half a second rolled off. Now, again, advancing to the forecourt. Down by six. You got to go quick. And here comes Coleman back to the scorer's table to check in for Coppin State. First pass in this offensive set is the key. It's got to be quick.
And you got to get it to either one of two people, in my opinion. You get it to you give it to number four, or you give it to number 23.
Well, I have a sneaking suspicion that Coach Lewis is going to have both those people covered up, so maybe a third option for Coleman.
Even if you can get it, even you can get it to Fields or Graham and try to turn to the basket and pick up a foul. And Angel Golden is in her normal defensive stance. Fields.
Score!
Got a score. And she gets a foul from Harris. And she's going to the line. That's five fouls on Harris. And it only took 2 seconds for that. Less than 2 seconds. So Brooke can cut 2 points out anyway.
Back in the 22, Neil White. Brooke Fields at the line. 2 shots for an Eagle.
Coppin is out of timeouts.
Brooke goes to the line. First of two on the way. Good. Second shot. It's good, too. Now Bethune-Cookman wants to take a timeout. Take a full timeout. 69-65. Coppin State has scratched away at this time.
Yeah, 8.4 to go. Ball will be advanced to the forecourt. Sahai Corby's back in. Her job is to foul immediately if Coppin can't get the steal. Down four with 8.4 to go.
You know who they'd like to put. You know who they would like to put on the line. Would be Angel Golden. Is who they would like to put on the line. That ball is inbounded. It will be to Angel Golden, most likely. and that's who Coppin State will have to foul. Oh, here we go. Players are stacked up. Walker will throw it in.
You got a foul.
Walker gets it. Oh, there's a foul already. Took about 2 seconds for that.
Yeah, Golden ran to the backcourt, stumbled down. Everybody kind of paused. Ball came in freely.
I think the play was to get it to Golden way deep in the backcourt.
Yeah, and then critical time rolls off.
So now Walker will go to the line, a 63% free throw shooter. Bounces in. Bethune Cookman up by five. Closing seconds. Second shot on the way. It's good. Chance to Corby. 2 seconds left. One. The floater, she picks up the foul. No, she traveled. So there's only 0.1 second left. And this one's almost in the books. That'll do it. Final score, Bethune-Cookman 71, Coppin State 65. Comments, sir?
Well, when you work so hard with a 25-10 run to get back even at 49, and then your opponent scores 12 unanswered, that really is the difference in the game, Dan, and then Coppin just couldn't recover after that. And Coach Burroughs getting set to join us here after a tough one here at home and a heartbreaker, to say the least. Coach, we were just talking about it a moment ago. 25-10 run to get back even at 49 with 7:41 to go. And then it seemed like Bethune-Cookman ran away with it with 12 unanswered.
No, we just ran out of gas. You know, we do what we normally do, which I was hoping we didn't do today, was come out in the third quarter and, you know, spot them 7, 8, 9, 10 points, and we did. You know, and then it's uphill fight for that. And I told him at halftime, Bethune was going to allow you to make the mistakes, and they just were going to capitalize on your mistakes, and that's exactly what happened.
Chance another double-double, and again, Brooke Fields in double figures.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Chance a double-double, and Brooke with double figures, and Mariah had 13. He's got to get production from other people. And again, you know, their bench out score is 17-7, and I've been on my bench. They have to score the basketball when they get in the game, and we're just not doing a good job of scoring the basketball off the bench.
So now, less than a week to prepare for the Battle of Baltimore. What's your expectation with Morgan coming to town, or across town, I should say,
you know,
on Saturday?
Ed's going to have his team prepared. You know, it's just a matter. It's a cross-town rivalry. It's a matter who wants it more. You know, they come here. Last year, I think we split. We beat them here, and they beat us over there. So hopefully this year, you know, we try to coach every basketball game. But one of the things we've been trying to do is protect home, and we haven't really done a great job of protecting home. Like a game like tonight that we just let get away from us.
Appreciate the time as always. See you on Saturday.
Thank you.
There is head coach Dwayne Burroughs here after a tough one. And Dan Mason, as I turn back to you as well, this was a very winnable game for Coppin State. They're down three at the break. And as we talked about, that critical third quarter, 21-2 in favor of Bethune-Cookman from the end of the second, middle of the third. And then Coppin makes this great run in the third, into the fourth, 25-10. And this coach just mentioned they ran out of gas.
You know, it's hard. It's very hard to look at our team and not see progress. There is progress. You know, this same Bethune-Cookman team came in here last year and really manhandled us in our own home floor. But this year, you know, and our team fought hard. They didn't give up. They didn't quit. But Coach put it succinctly. We ran out of gas. More players got into the game. Mariah had a really good game. She had scored 13 tonight, 5 for 9 from the floor. Can't complain about that. Did a good job and made some key baskets in that stretch run.
Chaz Brown goes for 18. Angel Golden goes for 16. And as I mentioned previously, Coppin 3 in double figures. Brooke with 23, Chance with 16, and then Mariah with 13.
Well, we're going to get another test coming up Saturday, so we're going to get more looks, and we'll see. So thank you for joining us tonight. Stand by for the men's game for our fine crew here at Coppin State, our production crew, for my partner Todd Bartley. I'm Dan Mason. Good night.